لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ غدوت من أهلك تبوئ المؤمنين مقاعد للقتال والله سميع عليم إذ همت طائفتان منكم أن تفشلا والله وليهما وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون ولقد نصركم الله ببدر وأنتم أذلة فاتقوا الله لعلكم تشكرون صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى آمين يا رب العالمين. From the 13th section of Surah Al Imran. Now a very long discourse which contains commentary from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the events of the Battle of Uhud. This battle was fought in the month of Shawwal, in the third year after Hijrah. And when that was actually, according to the Arabic tradition, that because at Badr, the Quraysh of Makkah had a very bad defeat, now they had to take the revenge. So they made full preparations. An army 3,000 strong, a very big army by the standards of those days, well armed, well provided. It reached the vicinity of Medina. Then there was a consultation held by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His own opinion was that we should defend Medina while remaining in the city and not go out. The same was the opinion of the chief of the Munafiqeen, Abdullah ibn Ubay. Incidentally, he also held the same opinion. But the Prophet saw sallallahu alaihi wasallam that many youth, especially the young people, especially those who had either entered Islam after the Battle of Badr, or although they were Muslims already before Badr, but they couldn't go to Badr, they were very anxious to go and have a direct combat, man to man, face to face fight. And they said, we need the Shahada, martyrdom. So why should we go in the open field and confront the enemies of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he cared for the sentiments that they had and decided finally, okay, we shall go out and fight the enemy in the open field. Then he set forth from Medina with 1,000 men. But after he reached the battlefield, Abdullah ibn Ubay with 300 of his companions, he deserted. He went back to Medina. He said, when our opinions are not respected, why should we risk our lives? So now it was a big setback, a big shock. Already they were one-third in number. 1,000 were to face 3,000. Now you know the ratio proportion was reduced to 1/4. Now there were only 700 who had to face 3,000 strong army, well provided, well armed. Anyhow, when the fighting began, Muslims were victorious. And very soon, you know, the army of the Quraysh from Makkah, they were on their heels, they were running off. But at that time there was a mistake committed by 35 persons of Muslims. The Prophet had posted 50 men. There was a pass behind the position of the Muslims. And there could be that the enemy cavalry could charge through that pass. So Prophet posted sallallahu alaihi wasallam 50 archers at that place to keep the enemy at bay. But when they saw those 50 people, that the battle has been decided and Muslims have got the victory. The enemy forces are running, so they left the place. Although the commander who was posted there, he said to them till the last moment, don't leave this place. Remember the instructions of the Prophet that you will never in any case leave this place. You will remain here. But out of 50-35, they disobeyed him, they left the place. Khalid ibn Walid was leading the cavalry, 100 horse strong cavalry they had. He saw that moment and he encircled the mountain, and from that pass he charged. And that actually was a very bad moment for the Muslims. The victory changed into defeat. 70 of the Sahaba were martyred. The Prophet himself was wounded. So this was a big shock to the Muslims. 1 year after Badr. Badr was, you know, a source of big support. The morale of the Muslims had gone high after Badr. They had defeated Quraysh. 3 times their number. So in the whole of Arabian Peninsula, the Muslims, you know, got a very high name. But now the wind was gone. The conditions were changed. Now this 60 ayat long, you know, there is a discourse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are comments. What are the weaknesses, O Muslims? You should see the weaknesses in your ranks. You must mend your ways, because the struggle is still going on. You'll have to face harder positions, harder situations. So whatever weaknesses have come to the surface, you must try to remedy them. This is the basic subject of the coming 60 ayat. I can't say how many of them we shall be able to read today. وَإِذْ غَدَوْتَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ. And just recall, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when you left your family in the early morning, تُبَوِّعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مَقْعِدَ لِلْقِتَالِ, you were assigning the Muslims their stations and positions, you are posting them for the battle. وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ, and Allah is all-hearing, all-knowing. إِذْ هَمَّتْ طَائِفَتَانِ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ تَفْشَلَا. It's very noteworthy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't even mention the munafiqeen here. The bigger event was that 300 deserted. But that incident has not been discussed here, as if they are not worth mentioning. Instead, among the Muslims, the remaining 700, two small groups were there who showed some weakness. They have been mentioned here. Is hammat ta'ifatan minkum an tafshala. When two parties of you were about to lose heart, they were Banu Harsa and Banu Salma, two families. They saw, you know, the difference in number, and for some time, for temporarily, there was weakness in their wills. Is hammat ta'ifatan minkum an tafshala, wallahu waliyuhuma. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was their protector, supporter, helper, they shouldn't have felt weak when Allah was on their side. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And people who really believe, they should have all their trust in Allah, not in the numbers, not in the arms. All their trust should be in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyhow, it was a temporary phase. They then made up their mind, they stood. They remained there, they fought with the Muslims, and they were very proud later on that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned us in Quran, and He has referred to us as Hammat Taifatane Minkum. They are from amongst you, O Muslims. They are not the hypocrites, they are not the munafiqeen, they are two groups from among yourself. So they were very proud that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used these words about us. Is Hammat Taifatane Minkum an tafshala. وَاللَّهُ وَلِيُّهُمَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had helped you in Badr. It was only 1 year before. وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ. And you were very weak, very weak. Because at Badr, Muslims didn't have even arms. I think only 7 had swords with them. Only 7 of them. Because actually, when they started from Medina, They never knew that they had to fight an army. They thought that we have to go after the caravan. So they didn't need all the arms with them. وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ. And Allah had helped you at Badr, although you were very weak. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So you should have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you can be really grateful to Him.